بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم السلام عليكم Today we have our next lecture of topic pharmacovigilance and in the last lecture we studied classification of adverse drug reactions based on severity of adverse drug reaction and now we have another classification of adverse drug reaction given by Roberts and Thompson that is also the traditional classification of adverse drug reactions and according to them the adverse drug reactions are classified into two categories type A reactions and type B reactions type A reactions account for 95% whereas type B reactions account for 5% Type A reactions are also called augmented reactions and these are common, predictable and mostly identified before marketing the drug means in phase 1 to phase 3 of clinical trials. Most of them are predictable. These adverse reactions are dose related and result directly from the pharmacological response of the drug and it can be due to drug-drug interaction and drug-food interaction. Basically, it can be due to drug interaction. It can be with food or with any other substance. Some of the effects representing in type A reactions such as excessive effects of pharmacological action of the drug. And example include hemorrhage with anticoagulants and it can be unwanted pharmacological action of a drug, for example, anti-muscarinic effects of TCA, tricyclic antidepressant drugs, which include blood vision, tachycardia, dryness of mouth, and urinary retention. There can be withdrawal reactions. Most of the some of the drug representing withdrawal effect means when the drug is ceased, then the adverse drug reaction are exhibiting, and such reactions include like insomnia with hypnotic drugs. When the drug is reused, the symptom disappears. Type B of bizarre reactions. Bizarre means unintentional, and as these reactions are unexpected and unrelated to the known pharmacological effect of the drug, and these are uncommon and unpredictable, and these are not related with dose or relation has relation with pharmacological action of the drug. The site where the effects can be observed: liver, skin, and hematopoietic system. Reactions normally occur in this class of adverse drug reaction include hypersensitivity reaction or allergic reactions, such as anaphylaxis from penicillin. They may be affected by genetic or environmental factors and are frequently not discovered until the drug is marketed. The term is related with type B reaction, which is idiosyncrasy, and some of the type B reactions also called idiosyncrasy. And what is it basically? It is the genetically determined abnormal reactivity to a chemical, thus certain desired drug effects due to peculiarities of an individual for which no definite genotype has been described, and they may be included, and they are included as drug interacts with some unique feature of the individual that not found in majority of the subject. So only few subject showing such reaction, and they produce uncharacteristic reaction. For example, barbiturate, excitement and mental confusion in some individual. Another example, quinine, showing cramps, diarrhea, eczema, vascular collapse in some of the individuals. So if we summarize these two type of adverse reactions and their characteristics, so type A reactions are normal and showing augmented response, but they are predicted from pharmacological action of the drug. They are related to dose and reasonably occur commonly, and their response rarely fatal. Mean symptom may be improved or symptom may be reduced, ceased when the drug is withdrawn. Whereas type B reaction are abnormal and bizarre response, unintentional, unpredictable from the pharmacology of the drug, not related with the dose, and reasonably uncommon. And they often cause serious fatal response or illness or death can occur. Another classification given by Wilson Brown, and it depends, this classification depends on the mechanism. Type A augmented reaction, which is dose-related and pharmacologically predictable. And the symptoms improve when the medication is ceased and are occur commonly. Type B, Merck's reaction, not related with the dose and pharmacologically predictable. Merck's is basically representing the microorganism where they have their increased growth. For example, sugar-coated drugs may induce the dental crisis. So it involves, such reaction involve with the involvement of microorganism, and symptom may be improved if the medicine is withdrawn. Means the drug which is responsible, like sugar-coated drug, if they are removed or changed, so the growth of microorganism negatively impacted. So that's why the reaction can be ceased. Type C, chemical or chronic reaction, dose related and time related. They are not pharmacologically predictable, but may be seen or may be based on the knowledge of physiochemical characteristics of the drug. It is basically the chemical nature of the drug which can cause such a reaction, and that's also called irritant reaction, that is related to the quantity of the drug or concentration of the drug. For example, contact dermatitis, an example of type C or chemical adverse reaction. Type D, delivery or delayed reaction. These are independent of chemical as well as pharmacological properties of such drug, and occur due to the method of administration or nature of the drug formulation. For example, the infection at the site of injection, when the route is changed, so this effect can be ceased or the effect can be controlled. Type E, exit or end use effect or reactions, which is related with the withdrawal of the drug mean the adverse drug reaction exhibiting when the drug is withdrawn, and the symptom can be improved when the drug is start again. For example, withdrawal seizure, withdrawal effect like seizure when the anticonvulsant like phenytoin is withdrawn. Similarly, the drug when the drug is start, so the patient can improve. Now, type F, familiar or failure reaction, failure of therapies. They can only occur genetically predisposed patient. When the patient is predisposed genetically, so such type of reaction can be resulting, and it can be improved if the medicine is withdrawn. For example, hemolytic anemia with primaquine in the individual who are glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase deficient. Now type G, genotoxicity. This is very historically known reaction, and it is irreversible, cannot be treated, and it causes reversible genetic damage such as teratogenic effect, which was occurred by the use of thalidomide. There was genetic damage, and the fetus was with deformities of limbs with phocomelia. They had deformed limbs, and it was because of irreversible genetic damage. Now, type H, hypersensitivity reaction. They are also known as drug allergy, and it's associated with the immune mediated response. So the drug allergy are categorized under the class of type H reactions. The last one, type U, unclassified reaction, where we cannot classify the reaction in above mentioned classes of the drug reaction. And these include the reaction where the mechanism is unclear. For example, taste disturbances with simvastatin. It is unclear by the mechanism, so it is classified under the class of U, type U adverse drug reactions. So after the classification based on the mechanism of adverse drug reaction, we have another classification based on the onset of event that include acute, means the symptom of adverse drug reaction occur within 60 minutes of drug administration, maybe 60 or less than 60. Subacute reaction occur in within 1 to 24 hours. And latent adverse drug reaction means the reactions occur after 2 or more than 2 days of the ingestion of such drug or administration of the drug. We are having some of the factors which are responsible to initiate the adverse drug reaction, or which are associated with, which are the risk factor of adverse drug reactions. So here we have predisposing factors of adverse drug reaction that include polypharmacy. Polypharmacy basically means that the patient have multiple drugs, so the chances of adverse drug reaction are increased, maybe due to drug interaction, or it may be due to synergism effect, or due to mechanism. So that adverse drug reaction due to polypharmacy or multiple drug administration may be due to the mechanism or mechanism of the drug, metabolism, pharmacokinetics, or different other depends on where the drug are going to interact with each other, and there can be synergistic effect and antagonism effect of the drug can be. So synergism can be a cross drug reaction due to administration of multiple drugs. Similarly, multiple and intercurrent diseases can also be responsible for adverse drug reactions, because with multiple diseases, the organs involved in drug handling or drug pharmacokinetics, they can be show their altered response or adverse drug reaction can resulting. For example, venerohepatic impairment are at increased risk of adverse drug reaction, because liver is so mostly associated with the drug metabolism, and kidney are really responsible for elimination of the drug. And if these two are under disease condition or are impaired, so their pharmacokinetics are compromised, and they can result in adverse drug reactions. Now, age is also a factor of adverse drug reaction, because in elderly we know that their decline physiological functioning of that individual who are aged, and so reduce elimination or reduce metabolism can occur, and in toxicity of the drug can be resulting even if the drug is not eliminating properly. So chances of adverse drug reaction are increased. Similarly, in neonates, we are different who are different reacting or handling the drug, so there are also risk of adverse drug reaction in neonates due to difference in their handling of the drug capacity, and they are as comparatively at higher risk of adverse drug reaction. For example, Gray baby syndrome is adverse drug reaction with chloramphenicol. Chloramphenicol causing Gray baby syndrome. It is also reported. Gender. Gender also very important factor of adverse reaction, because women are genetically at greater risk because of their difference in pharmacokinetics and hormonal changes compared to male. So, for example, chloramphenicol induces aplastic anemia, and phenylbutazone inducing agranulocytosis are twice or thrice common in women as compared to men. Race also have the relation with the pharmacokinetics of the drug. That's why ethnic origin may affect the drug metabolism. Genetics, very importantly, important factor. Genetic factor is very important factor of adverse reaction, and such reaction common in genetically predisposed individuals and patients who are genetically like glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase deficient people are at increased risk of hemolysis when due to premature when they are taking. Drug characteristic related with adverse drug reaction. Some drugs are highly toxic in nature, like anti-cancer drug and nanotherapeutic index drug like digoxin. So by the nature, they are having potential to cause adverse drug reaction. It's very important to understand mechanism of different type of reaction. We have here mechanism of type A adverse drug reactions. In type A adverse drug reaction, there can be different causes There can be pharmaceutical causes, pharmacokinetic causes, and pharmacodynamic causes. First of all, coming towards pharmaceutical causes. As we know, there can be change in the quantity of the drug during the formulation and their release spectrum. So if the changing in their formulation occur, they can also cause, or they are responsible potentially to cause a gross drug reaction. For example, endomethacin can cause GI bleeding if their control pattern is disturbed and the drug is released out of their control pattern, because it is another control release drug, and if this formulation is disturbed, increase concentration of the drug in GI, causing GI bleeding. Similarly, doxycycline salt can also cause corrosive effect on the esophagus. So the changing of the salt can improve this cause and that first reaction. Now the pharmacokinetic causes, the disturbances or alteration at the level of absorption, distribution, metabolism, and elimination of the drug can cause adverse drug reaction. When the medicine is taken, they are absorbed. Normally, oral drug require absorption, and then it will go to the desired site, to the transporter, and the drug is metabolized normally by the liver, and finally they are excreted. So the dysfunctioning of all such four parameters of pharmacokinetics can cause adverse drug reactions. Absorption, alteration in the rate and extent of the drug badly affect the absorption of the drug, which is directly related to their bioavailability for their pharmacological response, which can be towards the toxic effect or to the treatment failure if the absorption is affected. Greatly absorb the drug, so toxicity chances is increased, whereas if less absorption of the drug occurs, so the treatment failure can be there. So GI motility is related with the drug absorption. If there is dysfunctioning or reduce or increase the GI motility, so the drug absorption is affecting. If the time required for the drug to be absorbed is reduced, so it is not absorbed in the circulation and the desired effects are reduced. And if the absorption or the time required for the absorption is increased, so the large amount of the drug or the higher quantity of the drug is absorbed in the serum and it can produce its toxicity. First pass metabolism can also affect the content of the drug, and it the biotransformations occur for the certain drug, due to which the reduced concentration occur before their systemic concentration, that is ultimately resulting in their desired response to that individual. So it is also responsible for altering the absorption of the drug. Now the concomitant administration of drug, if the drug is administered with another drug, so there can be increase or decrease absorption of the drug. So there can be altered absorption, which ultimately resulting in their altered therapeutic response. So interaction of the drug can occur at the level of absorption. That we have already studied when we were studying the drug interaction. Now the absorptive capacity of GI mucosa is also responsible for absorption of the drug. If the GI mucosa is disturbed and higher concentration is absorbed in the GI due to maybe due to certain disease in the GI mucosa that will that may cause toxicity of that drug. And on the other hand, if drug is not absorption absorbing, maybe due to their genetic factor, and they are not able to individual is not able to absorb the drug as it is required for their therapeutic effect. So in certain in both the cases, the absorption is affecting and causing the alteration in the required therapeutic response of such drug. Distribution. When the drug is absorbed after oral absorption, and they are now ready to go to their target site by different transporters. So different factors are involved in their distribution. Regional blood flow. If the blood flow is proper, so drug is reached to the target site and their transporter. Drug is protein binding, so they require protein. If the protein are not available, so they can also disturb the distribution, as well as the permeability of the tissue to transport the drug. These all three factors are responsible for the desired pharmacological action of the drug, and thus these factors are also related to the adverse drug effect if they are altered due to any reason. Now, the third parameter of the pharmacokinetic is metabolism, which is normally occurred by the liver. So, increased rate of metabolism can cause therapeutic failure, and decreased rate of metabolism can cause increased risk of adverse reactions, because in case of decreased rate of metabolism, drug concentration is high, and that is that may be responsible for toxicity of the drug or adverse reaction. On the other hand, if the metabolism is increased, so excessive drug are metabolized and are not available for the therapeutic response, so therapeutic failure can be resulted. Certain factors like genetic environmental factor can also affect the metabolism, such as if acetylation process is slow, so metabolism of certain drug like isoniazid and dapsone is affected. So slow metabolism of the drug can cause increased risk of adverse drug reaction. The last parameter, elimination. Elimination of the drug is very important regarding adverse drug reaction. If the elimination of drug is not proper, so increased concentration of the drug in the body is present to produce toxicity or adverse reaction. It may be due to impairment of kidney, which is responsible normally to eliminate the drug from the body. So in this condition, if the reduced elimination of the drug is there, so increased chances of adverse reaction are there. Whereas increased elimination rate of the drug consequently causing therapeutic failure, because drug is not available for producing its therapeutic response. So it's all about today's lecture. Inshallah, we will continue our topic in the next lecture. Allah Hafiz.